Popful Mail was filmed in front of a live studio audience. Hi. I'm kind of burning the midnight oil again on this one. And I'm sorry that tardiness has sort of become a recurring feature of this LP. But you know, other than being late, I'm pretty happy with how consistent I've been with the schedule for this LP. I'm not always able to get them out on time, but I have been able to put out 3 updates a week, which is better than I used to be able to do. Consistency has not always been my strong suit. By the way, when you hold down the attack button with Tats or a staff, it sort of seeks out the enemy, which is really cool. So yeah, apologies for the lateness, but I hope you have enjoyed actually having updates more or less on time every week. The reason I was late today was because Moores and I went to go see the film Pacific Rim, and my 3-word review of it, which I published on Twitter, is dumb and awesome. That pretty much sums up the movie. It is definitely a turn off certain parts of your brain kind of movie. There's a lot of dumb stuff, a lot of moments where you say, wait a minute, why is that happening that way? There's no way that would actually happen this way, and you just have to ignore that part of your brain because you're watching the best depiction of giant robots fighting giant monsters ever made. Hey, who are you calling dorky? Oh, me? Okay. That's accurate. Just wanted to make sure. So yes, Pacific Rim. There's a place for movies like that. Sure, I'm fond of, you know, quirky independent movies with a lot of talking, you know, quote-unquote films as opposed to quote-unquote movies. But a big, dumb summer action movie is perfectly fine. Nothing wrong with it at all. And this one is probably one of the best. I put it up there with, like, the Avengers in terms of quality. So yes, this has been Duke's Movie Corner. Thanks for watching. We now return you to your regularly scheduled video games. Unlike a lot of recent Popful Mail episodes, this one is actually going to be more gameplay than cutscene. I know! It's shocking. I don't know how they did it. And that's why I am currently taking damage, because you actually have to do something in this level besides just walk to the boss and then fight the boss. Unlike the last couple of episodes. But I have plenty of apples and bananas. Damn it. Those things only deal 1 point of damage, so I'm not too concerned about those. This is the door that requires a key. I think that's only the second time in the game we've actually gotten a key. That thing's been in the HUD this whole time, but you hardly use it. Item screen? Stone shoes? What's this madness? Well, when I bought that item, I forgot that I would need it here, but I'm glad I bought it, because that's the only way to get past those spikes without taking damage. And those spikes actually hurt, unlike the spiky ball things. Alright, this boss should not pose too much of a challenge, but I'm going to save it here anyway. The last boss was pretty good, but we're back to stand in one place and cheese the boss. Well, it's a little more complicated than that. Unauthorized personnel? But I swiped my card. Okay. This boss is all about timing. As long as you jump at exactly the right time, which is just a split second after the fire appears in his mouth, you will not get hit by these spikes. There is a platform over to the right that you can stand on and avoid the spikes entirely, but if you go to the right, then he starts throwing other attacks at you, and the fight just becomes more complicated. Much easier to just do it this way. And the reason I switched to male and I'm standing so close to him is because I can still hit him even after the projectile ammo runs out. I know this is not entertaining, but that is the best way to deal with it. And you know, part of the purpose of these LPs is, you know, a video walkthrough, theoretically, so people can watch these if they get stuck in the game and realize, oh, so that's how I fight that boss. And the gate magically opened after I killed that thing, for some reason. Well, that was satisfying. Sneak preview of the next area. Hassle Hall. Ooh, sounds foreboding. This area is a hassle. Alright guys, so in conclusion, video games, go see Pacific Rim if you want a big, dumb action movie about giant robots beating the crap out of giant alien monsters. Because it is really dumb and cool. And I will be back with you on Friday. If you're watching this on Wednesday tonight or Thursday, then there's going to be a stream, probably Terraria, 7 p.m. as usual. You can check out dukeofthebomb.com for the details, and I will see you either there or on Friday. Later.